So in this video, I want to test the divergence theorem. So the divergence theorem is this integral over the volume of del dot u dv equals the integral, the surface integral over the surface enclosing the volume of u dot ds, where ds is the normal vector to the surface pointing outward from the volume and times the element area ds. To test the divergence theorem means I want to compute both sides of this equation and show you that they're equal. So we're going to test the divergence theorem using a vector field u, which is xy times I plus yz times j plus zx times k for a cube of side L lying in the first octant, which means that x, y, and z are all positive here. The faces of the cube are in the planes of the axes. Okay, so let's start with the right-hand side. So to compute the integral over the volume of the divergence of u, we need the divergence of u. So we have del dot u. Remember, this is the partial of u1 with respect to x, which is a derivative of xy with respect to x is y, plus the partial of u2 with respect to y. The derivative of yz with respect to y is z, plus the partial of u3 with respect to z. The derivative of zx with respect to z is x. Okay, so that's x plus y plus z. So now we want to compute this volume integral. So we're computing the volume integral, which is a triple integral of del dot u, which is x plus y plus z. And we're integrating over a cube, so that's a simple integration. So integrating dx, dy, dz. The sides are length L. The lower back corner is at the origin. So each of these integrals then go from 0 to L. Okay, straightforward integral. Remember, x, y, and z are dummy variables. So the integral, triple integral over x of dx, dy, dz is the same as the triple integral over y of dx, dy, dz is the same as the triple integral over z. So this is just 3. And then let's just do the x one. So then we have dy, dz, so we can separate, we can factor. So 0 to L dz, 0 to L dy, and then 0 to L of x dx. So this will be L, L. This is x squared over 2, so is L squared over 2. So L times L times L squared over 2 times 3. So that becomes 3 L to the fourth, L squared, LL, L to the fourth, divided by 2. Okay, so this is the left side of the divergence theorem, right? So this is the integral of del dot u dv. So the right side of the divergence theorem, so this is the left side. So the right side, what do we need? We need the, we have the u is this function. We need the ds, okay? So there are 6 surfaces to integrate over, the 6 sides of the cube. One of them will be at x equals 0. So let's look at the ones that are in the planes of the axes. So one of them will be x equals 0. That's the back face. For that face, the normal vector is in the x direction. So u dot ds will just pick out the first component of u. But the first component of u is xy. And x is equal to 0 in the back face. So u then, the first component of u will be 0 on that back face. Okay? So the contribution to the back face will be 0. What about at y equals 0, this left side face here? At this side face, when y is equal to 0, then we have the normal vector is in the minus y direction, right? So that's minus j. And then we pick out, then u dot ds will pick out this third one, this yz piece here. But y is equal to 0, so that will be 0 also. The other one will be z equals 0 is the bottom. When z equals 0, then ds points along minus z. So that will pick out, u dot ds will pick out zx here, but z is 0, so that's also 0. Okay? So the faces with x equals 0, y equals 0, and z equals 0 will all give 0 contribution to the surface integral. So that remains 3 more faces. So we have x equal to L. So that's the face that's this way here, x equals L. And then what is ds there? So ds is in the I direction, right, in the positive x direction. And then we have to integrate dy and dz. So I dy dz. Okay, what about the other faces? So y equal to L, that is this face here on this side. And then the normal vector is in the y direction. So this is ds equal to j. And then we have to integrate x and z, so dx dz. And the last one will be z equal to L. And there ds, z equal to L. So ds is in the vector, normal vector is in the z direction, so it's k. And then we still have to integrate dx and dy. Okay, now we set up the right-hand side. So we get the right-hand side then is going to be equal to the integral over the surface of u dot ds. So we have three integrals here. We have one of the integrals will be u dot ds. So ds is I, so that's picking out I here, so it's xy, but x is equal to L, so that means ly times dy dz. So y then goes from a cube of side L, so it goes from 0 to L, and z goes from 0 to L, plus a second integral, which is at y equals L. So we have ds equals j dx dz. So j dot u dot j will be pick out yz. Y is equal to L, so that becomes lz. And then we're integrating dx dz from 0 to L, 0 to L. And then the last piece here is u dot ds, which is k here, so it picks out zx. Z is equal to L, so it becomes lx. And then we have dx dy. And that's from 0 to L, 0 to L. Okay, three integrals. But remember, y and z in the first integral are dummy variables. X and z are dummy variables. X and y are dummy variables. So in fact, all three integrals are identical. They're all the same. So we only need to do one of them, and it factors. So we get 3, and then L comes out. And then if we do the first one, we have 0 to L y dy and 0 to L dz. And we still have a little space to write the answer. So 0 to L dz is just L. 0 to L y dy will be y squared over 2 evaluated at L. So it's L squared over 2. So L squared over 2 times L is L cubed over 2 times L is L fourth divided by 2 times 3. So we get 3L to the fourth divided by 2. The same result, okay? So the left-hand side is calculating del dot u dv over the volume. The right-hand side is calculating the integral of u dot ds over the surface. And we both, in both cases, we get 3 times L to the fourth over 2. Okay, I hope I demonstrate now the divergence theorem for this particular case to show you that it works. You know, that's the thing about theorems in mathematics. They're supposed to always work. So if it didn't work, it means that I would have to reshoot the video because I made a mistake. But I didn't. We got a match. And that's the example of divergence theorem in Cartesian coordinates. Next up will be an example of the divergence theorem in spherical coordinates. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.